the most liquid on the stock exchange. And between the key players in those industries, you see a big mass as a proportion of the market capitalization of the Nigerian Stock Exchange. Mm-hmm. But despite that, we think that it's an industry, manufacturing industry specifically, that is really begging for a little more support from the government so that it can really harness the opportunities within this industry, as well as grow to the sort of levels that we are seeing. There are countries in the world where the manufacturing sector contributes even like 50% to the GDP of such countries. And that's the sort of ambition that we should be calling for Nigeria. I think we're saying that in another 3-4 years, we would like to see the manufacturing sector in Nigeria contributing about 50% to GDP. But there's a lot that needs to be done to provide the environment for the manufacturing industry to thrive and be able to achieve that ambition.
Okay, you mentioned support from the government. What kind of support do you think the government can give manufacturing industry to grow beyond its current limits?
Well, I think for a start, there's going to be some consistency around fiscal policies, because fiscal policies relating to cost of capital, relating to exchange rates and the likes of that can actually have a really material impact on the manufacturing sector. Okay, not least because a lot of activities, you know, have to do with importation, and there's so much capacity enhancement that is going on within the industry, capacity expansion, that is also leading to manufacturers having to do some borrowings to fund those capex investments. And because the cost of capital is so high, every funding that comes at such high interest rates tend to impact the profitability of the industry. And the more the industry's profitability is affected, then the more difficult it is to reinvest in the business. So that's one area that we would like to see the government really help intervene, get some stability around fiscal policies, help manage cost of capital, the work that the CBN is doing in terms of really managing the exchange rate and making it stable is laudable. They would like to see more of that into the future.
In your lecture, you mentioned less is more in manufacturing. Can you expatiate on that?
I mean, the concept of less is more is really about focusing on a few big scalable things and putting a lot of horsepower in terms of investment behind it to get maximum returns, as against doing too many little things that tend to dissipate energy and dilute operating margins and profitability. So that's the concept. Just pick a couple of big things and then put all of your resources, human and capital behind, so that you can get maximum returns from them.
Okay, finally, my last question is about risk. You said we should go for it, take risks. You know, and you mentioned the example of the Super Eagles and the risk we took. So what risks do you think Nigerians should take this 2014? How much risk do you think they should take?
Well, it would depend from person to person, depending on their economic state and what they can do. But my advice to Nigerians who are looking to make good, to really make 2014 come good for them economically, is that they should swing out. Swing out, meaning that, if you're not making a mistake, think about the fact that you're not making a mistake. Like I said in the lecture, that in itself is a mistake, because that means that you're not pushing the boundary. So push the boundary, stay in possibilities, do new things, take risks, and see what comes out of that.
Finally, I would like you to tell Nigerians out there something good, something positive that's going to happen in the manufacturing sector this 2014.
Well, obviously I'm not a soothsayer. The only thing I would say is that the manufacturing sector continues to be a big player as an industry of the Nigerian economy, within Nigerian economy. That's the first thing. The second thing is that we continue to invest in capacity enhancement within the industry. I think the automotive policy that the government came up with is a good one, but there are so many other considerations that will go with that to make that come to life, come to reality. But overall, my word to Nigerians is that as they have been doing, they should continue to be discerning in their choice of brands, and always ensure that they're getting good value for the money. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. That's been a pleasure.